It seems as though more and more people just don't seem to want to listen to the warnings given by God, particularly if you look at a specific warning that was given by Jesus. Today, without question, there are a lot of people who have this desire to be something special, this desire to show signs and miracles and so forth. The word of God is not enough, or just preaching the gospel, letting people know about the goodness of Christ, what he's done on the cross. That's not what they seem to be interested in. What they seem to be interested in is, one, putting on some signs and some miracles, which in many cases they really aren't signs and miracles, but then, two, being acknowledged for that rather than doing our first job, which is to share the gospel. If we go to Matthew chapter 7, verse 21, we'll find something interesting that I think that oftentimes gets overlooked, and we should not overlook it. It's not put there just haphazardly. There's a reason why Jesus says what he says. He says in Matthew chapter 7, verse 21, he says, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but he who does the will of my Father who is in heaven." Now, the issue is, first of all, he says, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,'" so meaning that there will be people who say or claim that they are a Christian or that Jesus is their Lord, and he's not. We'll see how we know so a little later on. But then he says, "But those who do the will of my Father who's in heaven." So the next question must be, what really is the will of God? Before we continue with the rest of Matthew chapter 7, verses 22, let's go and see what Jesus says this is the will of God. He says in John 6, starting verse 38, he says, "For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. This is the will of him who sent me, that of all that he has given me, that I shall lose none or nothing, but raise it up on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who beholds the Son and believes in him will have eternal life, and I myself will raise him up on the last day." So the will of the Father, as we look at what Jesus is saying, is that those that have been given him will be raised up. In other words, what he's pointing to, and he says so more so in verses 39 and 40, and that those who are believing in him will be raised up. So what's the will? That one, from our standpoint, is that we preach the gospel. Too many people don't have that as their first ministry. Rather, we've got a lot of people who their first ministry is doing two specific things that are called out by Jesus. So let's go back to the passages and look and see what Jesus specifically calls out. In verse 22 of Matthew chapter 7, he says, "Many will say to me on that day, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name and cast out demons in your name and in your name perform many miracles?'" So Jesus calls out two things specifically that we see a lot of today: people claiming to cast out demons and people who are also claiming to prophesy. Often cases, these prophecies are ultra vague. They rarely come true. And if they do come true, it's something so minuscule, something that we can all kind of see, such as maybe inflation is going to come about or something like that, that we can all even have secular people predicting different things that are going to happen or going to transpire in the world, which really aren't prophecies that are given by God. God has really no interest in, as far as we can see in scriptures, prophesying about such mundane things that don't affect the body. But these two things he calls out: casting out demons and prophecy. Why is that? Why did he mention that? Why did he mention any of the other things, such as tongues, even the aberrant use, the misuse of tongues, such as healing, even people, the false fake healers? He didn't call that out. He calls out two things: those who are claiming to be prophets and giving prophecies, and those who are casting out demons. Why is that? Jesus is giving a warning, and so we are just not paying attention. Well, I should say this: many are not paying attention. You see a lot of people who their ministry is still surrounded or centered around casting demons out, giving prophecies. But notice what Jesus says. Let's go back to it. He says in verse 23, "And I will declare to them, 'I never knew you. Depart from me, you who practice lawlessness.'" So I don't know you, indicating whether they are legitimate or illegitimate or not, they've said that they've cast out demons and prophesied. These people, that's their only focus. Their only focus is not doing the will of the Father, which is to be a light to people, to share the gospel. No, they'd rather do these other two things that Jesus, again, it's not as though Jesus couldn't call out any other thing, but he called out these two things specifically. The reason why is because we see a lot of people out there who want to tell you that they're out there doing the work of the Lord. They'll even put a nice little slogan on it that says that deliverance is the children's bread. That, by the way, is not in the scriptures. There's no such statement in the Bible that states that deliverance is the children's bread. Matter of fact, though, what we can find out is that Jesus is deliverance. He has come to deliver and set the captives free. If anyone has the Son, he is free indeed. Let's preach that. That is the will of the Father, not to go out and cast out demons, because if a person has Christ, he has no demon. He's not demonized. He's not possessed. He's not oppressed. Nor is God really after someone giving these vague, almost silly and laughable fake prophecies. No, if you want to be a true prophet, which is not necessarily the foretelling predictive prophecy, but saying what the word is, because prophecy, all it is just giving a revelation. Well, the greatest revelation that we have is what we see in scriptures. But we don't, that's not enough for a lot of people. We don't see them wanting to go to that and to preach that, which thereby will be part of God's will, which is leading people to Christ, hearing the gospel. They don't want to do that, which is probably why Jesus follows up by saying, "I never knew you. Depart from me, you workers of lawlessness." So if this is you, or you are attracted to that, you might beware. You might heed Jesus' warning and start moving away from those so-called ministries that only want to focus on that. Rather, you might want to find the ministries that want to teach the word and preach the word and have or seek to have the lost saved by the preaching of that word. Amen.